Welcome. My name is Melanie Remy. I am the solution architect of Securosys, and I explain you today the roles of the HSM. We will first talk about the standard roles that you need to have to operate the HSM, and later I will explain three optional roles that you could use as well. So let's start with the standard roles. In the beginning, you will have the genesis role, which is the bootstrapping role that you need to set up the HSM. You will receive a card and the PIN for the X device, or the genesis name and the PIN for the E device to set up the HSM with the initial wizard. The role holder who would hold the genesis role would be the team leader of the security team. We will explain later why. So during the initial visit, the first step is to create the security officers, which is the second role. There always two people need to be together to ensure a 4i principle. And we advise to onboard the complete security team. You can onboard up to 10 security officers, so you ensure that you always have two available. The security officers are managing the device. They set up the cloning, the clustering, they do the update, they can configure the policy, see the diagnostics. There are some features that they cannot do alone without their leader. These are the features who have a star. These are the important features. So like the remote management device, the Decanus pairing, the backup restore, and most importantly, the SO management. So the team leader is involved if the team members change and someone comes or leaves the company. You need to change the SO role. All the security officers feature can be done via UI, via command line tool with the serial port, or via the remote management device, the Decanus. One important feature for the customers is the actual partitioning. That's the key stores. Each partition is separated and has different credentials, and the security officer is managing the partitions and the credentials to log into these partitions. So the next role is actually the technical user, which will be an application who is logging into the partition with the API credentials, and the feature the application has is the actual key management. So the application can create keys and use the keys for signing or for encrypting. So the main reason why you buy HSM is for the application to use keys. If you have set up these three roles, you're able to use the HSM and you would be feature complete. But we have additional roles that you could choose to implement. One is the network management. You will only use the access password. And the network could also be configured by the Genesis or the SO role, but you could separate that and have a sysadmin or a data center employee to configure the network and make network diagnostics. An additional optional role is the partition security officers. The use case we have for that is the cloud, because we have a cloud service with multiple customers. Each customer owns a partition, so the HSM is multi-tenant capable. And the cloud customer have the need to manage their own partition and not leave everything to the cloud provider. So the partition SO will also authenticate itself with card and pins, and they will also connect with the partition Decanus with the remote management device. They can manage the partition, so the features are available are the user config, the user credentials, the partition backup restore, and the key invalidation. The next optional role is additional roles you can set up on the key itself, how the key can be used, so that you can put a policy onto the key. And there are different rules you can specify. One rule is to use the key for signing or decrypting. One is to block the key, to unblock, or to modify. For each of these features on the key, you can specify different groups and different quorums to separate roles on the actual operation on the key. This feature is optional, but it's widely popular. So I thank you for your attention, and if you have any further questions, please contact us.